Iowa surgeon is a pioneer in treating children with a rare polio-like illness.
Fox 2's Dan Gray has this Fox 2 exclusive. He's live at St. Louis Children's Hospital, where patients are showing some really remarkable results. Dan.
At Washington University, Dr. Amy Moore making a name for herself. Word is spreading fast about her specific kind of surgery that restores function to the legs of children paralyzed with a disease known as AFM, acute flaccid myelitis. And children from all over the country are coming here to St. Louis Children's Hospital for this specialized surgery. One of those kids came back today for a follow-up visit. In 2016, 6-year-old Brandon Noblet of Greenville, South Carolina, was a healthy baseball player. But one week that summer, everything changed.
We played baseball one Saturday. The next Saturday, we're hooked up in the hospital.
The symptoms started as a cold with headache and fever and progressed to neck pain.
It progressed quickly across the week. And Saturday, he woke up and couldn't move.
Brandon was diagnosed with AFM, acute flaccid myelitis. His right arm and leg were paralyzed. The family looked for answers at hospitals around the country. At Shriners Hospital in Philadelphia, the surgeon who performed a nerve transfer to get movement back into the little boy's right arm told them about Dr. Amy Moore in St. Louis, who had done the first nerve transfer in the legs of children with AFM.
Look at that.
Since 1996, we've been doing nerve transfers to restore function here. But we haven't applied them to the legs yet. And these children that gave me an opportunity to apply the same principles, the expectation that it should work. And thankfully, it is for some.
Go ahead and squeeze those toes.
Yay, look at that. It's getting so strong.
Dr. Moore has done 10 of the surgeries so far.
What I'm finding with my nerve transfers is that specific muscles that I've tried to give electric signal to are working.
Good job.
Brandon is out of a wheelchair and walks with a brace.
It means like everything, like being on the second floor of school, being able to go out to recess, having fun.
Brandon and his dad are very grateful to Washington University School of Medicine and Children's Hospital in St. Louis for the progress they've seen the boy make over the past year in regaining mobility in his legs. As far as the future, they know there may be additional surgeries and intense therapy.
If there's another AFM parent out there, I know you're in a dark place, but there is hope.
I would say just keep working, and sooner or later it's going to be all right.
Now Brandon's already practicing to get back to playing baseball, soccer, and basketball and football, and he says he wants to be, when he grows up, wants to be a surgeon so he can help other children. On Monday, the Centers for Disease Control is expected to release a new report on AFM. In the Central West End, I'm Dan Gray, Fox 2 News.